Hello, gaming group. Robert here from Black Belt Gaming. Continuing my playthrough of The Mage and Dragon Age Origins. I'm freshly... I have just arrived in Ostagar. And I'm here to... hopefully participate in the ceremony for joining the Grey Wardens. This was years ago that I played this game, and I thought there was some areas around here you could search. So before I cross the bridge, let's just see if there's anything to gather around here. Can't remember the exact year this game came out, but the computer I was playing on, and I think I mentioned this before, it was an expensive laptop. It was probably the first gaming computer I ever purchased. And I had to move here to Japan. I had sold the family cars, because of course we couldn't bring them here with us, and I think combining the money together from those two sales, I purchased a computer.
As you say.
Now both the cars were heavily used, and you know, I didn't get a lot of money for them, but it was a decent amount. But I purchased a really nice computer and a bunch of programs, and thought I was all set. Heard about this game, was really excited to get it. Ordered it, started playing it, was just loving it, and then it just overheated my machine. It was just too demanding on the graphics and burned out the cards in that laptop. Or burned out the main graphics card. And I think I was able to keep playing it, but I had to really tone the graphics down about as far as they could go. The computer just never was the same after that.
The Tower of Ishal is off limits. The men stationed inside are securing it now.
What is the tower?
I think they used it once to watch for wilders coming out of the forest.
And why is it off limits?
By orders of Taren Loghain. The tower is being secured by his men to be used during battle. I'm told they discovered some lower chambers, and they don't know how far down they go, so for now, everyone's to stay out. I didn't see anything like that when I was there, but who knows?
I should go.
Make a speed your steps.
Well, back when I started teaching here in Japan, one of my students, she was working on her English with me, and she was a freelance translator. And she said she had a big project she was working on, but she couldn't openly talk about it. She was told to kind of keep it quiet. And I wasn't sure why she was being so secretive.
Hey, you must be the Grey Warden recruit that Duncan brought.
Well, she brought in her work, and she said, "Can you help me with some of this? Some of this I'm not quite sure how to say it in English. I'm not really sure or what this means in English. I need to put it into Japanese." And she started reading some of the text from this document that she had. And then I immediately realized what she was working on. She was working on this game. And then I said, "You're working on Dragon Age." And her eyes just popped. And then I said, "The Kokari Wilds, Ostagar, Duncan, you're working on Dragon Age, aren't you?" And she's like, "How did you know? It's not even released here yet." And I said, "I'm playing the American version." And so She was thrilled that I could help her out. So it's kind of cool that one of my students worked on the Japanese version of Dragon Age. And I actually had a small hand in making that happen.
This place hasn't seen such bustle in centuries, I'll wager. Need a hand getting anywhere?
Let's see. I'm looking for a Grey Warden named Alistar.
Try heading north. I think he was sent with a message to the mages.
I'll be on my way.
Good luck to you then.
Heading north. He pointed back this way. Here are the mages there.
I'm sorry, but the mages must not be interrupted.
Templars. I don't like Templars.
We stand here in this hour, good folk of Ferelden, and we can't...
What do we have here? I heard the new Grey Warden recruit was from the Circle. I don't believe we've met, but I've certainly heard a lot about your talent. My name is Wynn, and I congratulate you on your harrowing, marvelous work. The Fade is a dangerous place.
All right, so we could either be arrogant here and say, nah, it wasn't that difficult. Or, yes, I know all about that, or I found it terrifying, to be honest. Well, I don't want her to come across as arrogant. I'm imagining this character to have great ambition. She's quite power-hungry, but wants to be free from the control of the Templars. Wouldn't even mind just bringing them down. But playing her cards right, she doesn't want to be too transparent. So let's say I found it terrifying, to be honest.
I thought the same. It's good you can admit that. So, a Grey Warden fighting alongside the King. Not too shabby for someone just out of apprenticeship.
King Kaelin thinks the battle will go well.
The King must always seem confident. His behavior affects the troops' morale. He does seem to find his enthusiasm easily, though. Reminds me of a puppy. And I say that with both respect and affection. He is a fine man. To defeat the Darkspawn, we have to work together. It's not an idea everyone seems able to grasp.
You faced Darkspawn before?
Stragglers, yes. Not the vast horde the scouts speak of. I wonder, how much do you know of the connection between Darkspawn and the Fade?
I know the Fade is where you go when you dream.
Anytime your spirit leaves your earthly body, whether it's to dream or to die, it passes into the realm we call the Fade. It's home to many spirits, some benevolent, others far less so. At the heart of the Fade lies the Black City.
And what is the Black City?
Some say the Black City was once the seat of the Maker. But when the mages from the Devinter Imperium found a way into the city, it was tainted with their sin. That taint transformed those men, turning them into twisted reflections of their own hearts. And the Maker cast them back to the Earth, where they became the first Darkspawn. At least, that's what the Chant of Light says.
I might let this slip out with a slight tone. The Chantry says many things.
It may be allegory, meant to teach us that our own evil causes human suffering. Or it may be true. It is as good an explanation as any for now.
At least it's something to ponder.
Yes, occasionally it's wise to contemplate one's actions. But I'm certain Duncan has more for you to do than talk to me.
Death is no failure, my friends. Should it find you, you will not have failed your king. You will have served your Maker. Die in this battle, and when you stand before the Maker in the land beyond the Fade.
So, any last wishes I can help fulfill before you head into battle? Life is fleeting, you know. That pretty face could be decorating some darkspawn spear this time tomorrow. Shall I take that quiet glare as a no?
Smooth, dude.
Oh, well, too bad. Well, you're not what I thought you'd be.
What did you think I'd be?
Not a woman, yet here you are. The name's Davith. It's about bloody time you came along. I was beginning to think they cooked this ritual up just for our benefit.
What do you know about the ritual?
I happened to be sneaking around camp last night, see, and I heard a couple of Grey Wardens talking. So, I listen in for a bit. I'm thinking they plan to send us into the wilds.
The wilds?
We're right on the northern edge of the Kokari wilds here. Miles and miles of savage country. My home village isn't far, and I grew up on tales about the wilds. Even been in there a few times. Scary place.
Why would they send us into the forest?
Sounds like some kind of test. Maybe we'll hunt us a souvenir or two. It's all too secretive for me. Makes my nose twitch. I guess we'll have to wait and see. Like we have a choice.
I'll watch your back if you watch mine.
Oh, I'll watch your back.
All right, where's the slap option? You're a charmer, I see.
That's me. Anyway, I expect it's time to get back to Duncan. That's where I'll be if you need me for anything.
A little chest over here, but it's all locked up. Okay.
Have you seen an elf running about? Young woman, red hair, carrying a suit of chain.
Can't say I have.
Blast it. Where did she go? That suit better be patched up when she gets back, or by the maker up. Oh, pardon my manners. My troubles are no concern of yours, I'm sure. I'm the quartermaster. Did you come for supplies?
What kind of supplies? Well, let me see what you have.
Let me know what you'd like.
Alright, let's see if there's anything we want to unload here. So that we don't just stack up our inventory. Well, we know we're not going to be using this mace. Not right now. We are using our wizardly powers, so I would say we could definitely drop We've definitely got the Beth staff. That was the one we weren't supposed to take. I guess let's just get rid of all these others. We're not going to need them. This blood dragon plate, I think that's something with the extra content for the game. So let's hang on to that. That might be useful to a party member later. I've got a small shield. I've got robes. We're definitely wearing the better set of robes. I can't remember how I got a chantry robe. Silver ring. It's just a silver ring, so let's get rid of that. A beef bone as a gift. Private documents. Let's unload some of these private documents and make some money. Blank. I think that's just paper. What else? I don't think we need this little shield. Leather boots. You know. Yeah, what we've got on is better. Get rid of those. Let's just hang on to the dagger for the moment. And that's about all we have. So 20 items left in the inventory. Is there anything? These health potions are always good. We can buy as many as 8 of them. How much would that cost us? About 9 silver. Let's go ahead and buy those up. Lesser injury kits, let's buy those up as well. I remember you can start accumulating injuries in this game and it just starts getting worse and worse for you. I evidently do have the ability to do some herbalism. So maybe picking up a few flasks. Why don't we start just with maybe 10 or so? 15, I guess. Let's go 15. 17 silver. And let's stop there and see what this herbalism might let us do. So elf root. Illyrium potion. Illyrium dust. Okay. We can use that dust we've collected to make a potion. All right, well, that's good. We can make use of some of that right away. Let's go to our inventory, and we've got 2 slots here for weapons. Let's at least use that dagger. Let's just have some kind of backup weapon. So here we're going to be doing damage. Is it 8.8? 7.8. So I guess if they do get right on top of us, using the dagger will be a little better. So we'll keep that in mind. Got the tranquil guy over here. Chest is locked.
Welcome, young woman.
You're a tranquil mage, aren't you?
Yes. And you are a mage of the Circle. You must be familiar with the Tranquil who serve there. I create and oversee the enchantment of weapons and armor for the King's forces here at Ostagar. It is a time-consuming process, but invaluable. Enchantment provides the Circle its wealth. Certainly, we would not get by on charity.
Well, let's just ask him about it.
It is the practice of folding magical lyrium into items first practiced by the dwarves. The Tranquil have learned their runes, and we use them to apply a variety of magical effects. We create the glow lights, as well as the magic staff, or the flaming blade. The irony, perhaps, is that it is our very disconnection to our former talents that allows the Tranquil to work with lyrium so. A true mage could not.
Really? What sort of
runes
enchantments?
Runes exist that hold the power of the elements that increase strength or swiftness. Almost any spell can be given permanency, given enough skill and lyrium. Naturally, the greater the power required, the more expensive the rune will become to create. True power comes with a price, as we know only too well. Goodbye. Right.
Crafting, what is herbalism, merchants, okay. Somebody in the middle section here looking for a quest. I feel like I remember this one. Isn't this one the dog?
This isn't good. I'd hate to waste such a promising member of the breed. Are you the new warden? I could use some help.
I don't know anything about dogs.
It's not what you know so much as what you are, really. This is a Mabari. Smart breed and strong. His owner died in the last battle, and the poor hound swallowed darkspawn blood. I have medicine that might help, but I need him muzzled first.
Why do you think I could muzzle him?
You're a Grey Warden, or soon will be. All wardens are immune to the darkspawn taint. The most you have to worry about is some tooth marks.
Well, I'm not a Grey Warden yet. Just how smart is this dog?
Centuries ago, a mage bred them to be smart and understand what they're told. They can remember and carry out complex orders. Most valuable dogs in the world. Trouble is, they generally imprint to one master. Reimprinting them is very difficult. But without the medicine, reimprinting won't be an issue. Will you help?
So these dogs are bred by mages. Could he be imprinted to me?
We can try, but first we need to muzzle and medicate him.
I'll give it a shot.
Go in the pen and let him smell you. We'll know right away if he'll respond. Let's hope this works. I'd really hate to have to put him down.
The dog looks, backing down from his aggressive stance. You can see intelligence as well as a great deal of pain. The animal is ill. Kill the dog. No, we don't want to kill the dog. Let's put the muzzle on the dog.
Well done. Now I can treat the dog properly, poor fella. Come to think of it, are you heading into the wilds anytime soon?
Well, I might be. Why?
There's a particular herb I could use to improve the dog's chances. It's a flower that grows in the swamps here, if I remember. If you happen across it, I could use it. It's very distinctive, all white, with a blood-red center.
You know, it would be nice to have a protector, so I'll see if I can find one.
Good. In the meantime, I'll begin treating our poor friend.
So she's doing this not just out of kindness in her heart, but she's doing this because she wants something in return. Like I said, I'm trying to play this a little differently than I did before. I'm not going just, you know, stupid, mean, and selfish, but more selfish and, what should I say, deceptive than I did in my first playthrough.
May you find favor in the Maker's eyes, so let it be.
I played a really good character before. Was, you know, didn't take rewards, was helping everybody he could. Just kind of the perfect hero. And like I said, that's very easy for me to play, very enjoyable, but I wanted to do something different. So I'm really going to see if I can live up to that. I don't know, does this guy talk?
Oh, someone!
Well, can you help?
You may not want to remain here long, Warden. Most of these men have been tainted by the Darkspawn blood.
What do we have here? No, he doesn't talk.
Huh. Someone finally comes and talks to the lone prisoner. I don't suppose you've come to sentence me.
No, I haven't.
I don't suppose you have a bit of kindness in you. All I want is food and water. They haven't fed me since I was locked up and I'm starving.
Why would I want to help you?
Because you might want something I don't need. Them circle wizards got a chest they keep things in. Magical things. And I stole the key. That's why I'm here. I got one of them drunk, took his key and tried to sneak to the chest. They assumed I was deserting. I can't use it from here, but I'd trade you for some food and water.
They didn't find the key when you were arrested?
I swallowed it, but it's come back into my possession since then, so to speak.
Okay. I'll take that, kill, kill him and take the key. I can't kill him. There's a guard right there. But she can say that's disgusting.
Yeah, well, do you want the key or not?
I'll see what I can do.
Just ask my guard for his. He's still got some dinner. I saw him put it in his coat.
All right. What do you say, guard?
Lucky dog. You Grey Wardens get to ride with the king while I'm left with the drudgery of guarding this deserter. They should have just hanged him. Put his head on a pike as an example.
It does seem a waste for you to guard him all day.
I can't just let him go, can I? The army will figure out what to do with him. Probably just waiting for someone important to make a decision. Then they'll hang him, I expect. And I can go and do something else.
I had a chat with him, actually.
Don't expect it was an enlightening conversation.
He asked for some food and water.
Did he now? Since nobody sends me nothing to feed him with, the only way we'll get that is if I give him mine.
Persuade. This is why I took some ranks in coercion. So, you miss one meal. This man could be hanged soon. Come on, don't be a
all
bad guy.
Right, all right. I guess the poor fella could stand to have one meal in his belly before he hangs. Don't know why you care. I had nothing to do with it, though. If anyone asks why he's burping, I'm gonna say it was you. Just so you know.
All right.
So? Brought me some food, have you? I'm so hungry I could faint dead away.
You better give me that key or I will kill you. Here's some food.
Much obliged. May Andraste herself rain blessings upon you. And, as I mentioned, here's the key. Use it in good health, huh?
It better work. It doesn't unlock this one. No.
Sorry, miss. The army camp is off limits for you right now.
No explanation, okay? Priest. Alright. Oh, some elf root. That reminds me, I think we can do a little brewing here. Let's make some of these lyrium potions. Get rid of this dust. And we've got 9 flasks. Let's go ahead and mix up this elf root. Cool. That's the dogs. There's Duncan. But we weren't supposed to see Duncan yet. Excuse me.
Soldiers of Pharrell, my sisters and gentlefolk, we stand here on the eve of battle. Let us consider the evil before us. In their pride, mages of the ancient Avenger Imperium.
Royal Enclave. King's Guard.
Greetings. King Kaelin is not in his tent right now.
Tell me about the king. You must see him a lot.
I suppose I do. Though he's spending most of his time with the Grey Wardens. He rides with them wherever they go, in fact. Taren Loghain sees the king whenever he can and argues with him over coming battles, but the king just waves him off. The king wants to end the Blight with a single huge battle the bards will sing of for centuries. Do you think that's possible?
We'll see in the coming battle.
That's how the Taren feels. He'll do what the king wants in the end, though. The king thought it was funny that Taren called him reckless, and they fought about the queen.
Fought about the queen? I didn't know Kaelin was married.
To the Terran's daughter, no less. He wasn't happy about something she did or the king did, I'm not sure. I probably shouldn't discuss it.
All right.
As you wish.
Look carefully, man. This wretched thing is a darkspawn. They're strong and cunning and smart, but don't listen to those old wives' tales. They can be killed. Stick them with your sword enough, and they go down. Their blood is black as sin and poisonous. Don't even touch it. You get tainted with that blood, and you may as well slit your throat. We've lost many dogs already. Had to muzzle them to keep them from biting. It's a long and painful way to die. Well, don't touch the carcass. We'll be burning it so it doesn't infect anything.
Wow.
There are lots of darkspawn, different kinds.
No, that one's locked.
Lots of things we've never even heard of. Our short friend here, for instance, is something called a Genlock. They're pretty common in the hall, but we've seen others much larger. We don't know where these new darkspawn are coming from.
There's a lonely little sack.
As you say.
Studded leather.
Of course.
A silver chalice? Maybe a couple of things to sell, huh?
Blessed art thou,
and a lone priest out here.
I shall not be left to wander the drifting roads of the Fade. I shall not be left to wander the drifting roads of the Fade. For there is no darkness, no death.
I want this nonsense talk stopped immediately.
Terran Loghain's guard.
You approach the tent of Terran Loghain. State your business.
Tell me about him.
How can you not know of Loghain? He helped free Ferelden. He was the brains behind King Marek's armies and drove out those damned Orlesians. King Marek rewarded him by making him a Terran. Can you imagine? A commoner became a high nobleman just like that. Without Loghain, you can bet the king wouldn't be winning against these darkspawn.
I should go. Kind of remember in my first playthrough that Terran Loghain was not a good guy. And I think I made some choices against him. Can't remember what they were exactly. But we'll see what happens this time. Might make some different choices this time around. That's the idea. Must be Alistar up there.
What is it now? Haven't Grey Wardens asked more than enough of the Circle?
I simply came to deliver a message from the revered mother, Sir Mage. She desires your presence.
What her reverence desires is of no concern to me. I am busy helping the Grey Wardens, by the King's orders, I might add.
Should I have asked her to write a note?
Tell her I will not be harassed in this manner.
Yes, I was harassing you by delivering a message.
Your glibness does you no credit.
Here I thought we were getting along so well. I was even going to name one of my children after you. The grumpy one.
Enough. I will speak to the woman if I must. Get out of my way, fool.
Are you talking to me?
No. One good thing about the Blight is how it brings people together.
Sorry, what?
Oh, nothing. Just trying to find a bright side to all this. Wait, we haven't met, have we? I don't suppose you happen to be another mage.
Would that make your day any worse?
Hardly. I just like to know my chances of being turned into a toad at any given moment. Wait, I do know who you are. You're Duncan's new recruit from the Circle of Magi. I should have recognized you right away. I apologize.
If you have a problem with my magic, say so now.
No problem. It's just my background makes mages nervous, and nervous mages make me nervous. I don't want to be a toad. I like the way I am. Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Alistair, the new Grey Warden. Though I guess you knew that. As the junior member of the Order, I'll be accompanying you when you prepare for the joining.
So this guy, I think, wasn't he a Templar before? What can you tell me about the joining?
Honestly, nothing. Try not to worry about it. It will just distract you. You know, it just occurred to me that there have never been many women in the Grey Wardens. I wonder why that is.
You want more women in the Wardens, do you?
Would that be so terrible? Not that I'm some drooling lecher or anything. Please stop looking at me like that. So I'm curious. Have you ever actually encountered Darkspawn before?
Have you?
When I fought my first one, I wasn't prepared for how monstrous it was. I can't say I'm looking forward to encountering another. Anyhow, whenever you're ready, let's get back to Duncan. I imagine he's eager to get things started.
That argument I saw, what was that about?
With the mage. The Circle is here at the King's request, and the Chantry doesn't like that one bit. They just love letting mages know how unwelcome they are, which puts me in a bit of an awkward position. I was once a Templar.
All right, I don't like you. You were a mage hunter?
Not that that's all Templars do, but yes, the Chantry raised me until Duncan recruited me 6 months ago. I'm sure the revered mother meant it as an insult, sending me as her messenger. And the mage picked right up on that. I never would have agreed to deliver it, but Duncan says we're all to cooperate and get along. Apparently they didn't get the same speech.
Let's go.
If you have any questions, let me know. Otherwise, lead on.
All right, he's in our party now. I do kind of remember he was a sword and shield fighter, and so was my dwarf. So I can't remember if I used him all the time in my party or not. We were kind of following a lot of the same battle skills. But here we go. I thought there was another recruit around here somewhere, but I don't know where. Let's go ahead and meet up with Duncan.
You found Alistair, did you? Good. I'll assume you're ready to begin preparations. Assuming, of course, that you're quite finished riling up mages, Alistair.
What can I say? The revered mother ambushed me. The way she wields guilt, they should stick her in the army.
She forced you to sass the mage, did she? We cannot afford to antagonize anyone, Alistair. We don't need to give anyone more ammunition against us.
I apologize, Duncan. I'll go collect who we're missing. This is Sir Jory, a knight from Redcliffe.
How do you do?
And this, of course, is the recruit that Duncan said he was bringing.
That's me, the new girl.
Now then, since you're all here, we can begin. You four will be heading into the Kokari Wilds to perform two tasks. The first is to obtain 3 vials of Darkspawn blood. One for each recruit.
One for each recruit, okay. I guess I am curious what the blood is used for, since I know it's toxic.
For the joining itself. I'll explain more once you've returned.
And what's the second test?
There was once a Grey Warden archive in the wilds, abandoned long ago when we could no longer afford to maintain such remote outposts. It has recently come to our attention that some scrolls have been left behind, magically sealed to protect them. Alistair, I want you to retrieve these scrolls if you can.
How will we find this archive?
It will be an overgrown ruin by now, but the sealed chest should remain intact. Alistair will guide you to the area you need to search.
And what if they're no longer there?
It's possible the scrolls may have been destroyed or even stolen, though the seal's magic should have protected them. Only a Grey Warden can break such a seal.
I don't understand. Why leave such things in a ruin if they're so valuable?
It was assumed that we would someday return. A great many things were assumed that have not held true.
What kind of scrolls are these?
Old treaties, if you're curious. Promises of support made to the Grey Wardens long ago. They were once considered only formalities. With so many having forgotten their commitments to us, I suspect it may be a good idea to have something to remind them with.
All right, find the archive and 3 vials of blood. Understood.
Watch over your charges, Alistair. Return quickly and safely.
We will.
Then may the Maker watch over your path. I will see you when you return.
Quick check of my inventory here. Gloves. Do I need to put on gloves? Maybe? I don't know if that is going to hurt me in any way. Like, I didn't play a mage before. Of course, I had at least one or two in my party, but... let's see. There's the mark, so it's this way. You know, I haven't been saving my game. Let's do that. So that's heading out into the wilds. Okay. Well, this may be a good stopping point for this video. Next video, we'll pick it up and be heading into the Kokari Wilds to look for Darkspawn blood, and these ancient treaties. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'll catch you later for some more Dragon Age.